Do you want to play Wargamer Dragon? But Eugene say, or you have no idea in the game? Fear not, in this video, I will cover a short basic tutorial in Wargame Red Dragon. If you are veteran player, great news, the game isn't dying. Wargamer Dragon is RTT game, while Wikipedia say it's RTS because it's written by someone who never played the game. In this game, you have only one resource. To get it, you must please politician at home by controlling more zone. Remember, they don't care about the life of their citizen, but about your endless conquest. This game have 3 mode: conquest, hold much zone as possible; destruction, destroy enemy unit as much as possible; and economy, make point as much as possible. But don't let your inner army commander spend too much, or you're gonna lose. Before the battle, let's start by building your own deck, because the default deck are created by someone questionable. They give new player creepy stuff or weird deck build and pretend it's okay. Okay, let's create your own deck. First, you must choose deck name whenever you like. Nobody will know your deck name unless it's me. Or you can put some Unicode to looks like this. You can also use this Unicode in the battle. Faction, capitalist blue or communist red. Nation / coalition, pick whenever you like, but for now, don't pick all or green nation coalition, because you will confuse by amount of unit. Type, select one of these, it mean you specialize your deck in certain way. It will limit your choice, so we gonna select all. After you get used to game, you might move to other type that suit your style. Here, just keep it on all unless you want suffering. Unit stat guide. You can hover your mouse to certain stat and get information there, but all are self-explanatory. Unit card have number of max card in it. If you click it, you will see a number of unit depend of the veterancy. Veterancy, you can choose quantity or quality. Remember, the more expensive the unit, the less you get. Unit have 3 slot of weapon. Usually, 2 slot are usable in combat. Weapon can deal HE or AP damage to deal with soft or hard target, or both. Weapons have accuracy and some have stabilizer display in a card. This is accuracy at max range, while this on moving. The closer you are, the better accuracy you get. Just like accuracy, kinetic AP power are more powerful in close range. Heat AP stay the same. Unlike kinetic that unable to deal damage if armor value larger, heat always deal 1 damage in that condition. Missile based weapon have guide system ranging from Mark 1 brain to real technology. Suppression make your enemy retarded so they can fight properly. Armor for only 4 vehicle that protect you from HE or AP. Zero, it's just piece of paper. It mean you take double damage, except for infantry. On one, it just reduce damage of small arm fire and take 1-to-1 damage. 2 and above, it's real armor, significantly protect you from HE and AP. Stealth show how hard the unit to be detect. Infantry have unique stat all training. The higher training you get, you will get better unit, but on more limited number. Also, infantry have 2-15 in squad, mean more HP, not firepower. Like infantry, are more faster and mostly using long range AT weapon. Vehicle have fuel and autonomy stat. Fuel didn't matter much, but autonomy are how long in second your vehicle can go. Land have ECM. This decrease accuracy of enemy firing accuracy to the plane. First step, logistic. In this step, you have CV and logistic unit. For creating a deck, you must have a CV. It's a unit for controlling the zone. You must have 1 CV on a zone to control it. If enemy have a CV in that zone, it became neutral. And you must kill or force move the enemy CV to gain back your zone. We can choose infantry, jeep, vehicle, tank, or helicopter. Basically, stealth, number, slightly armor, heavy armor, flying CV. We have 2 types of logistic, truck and helicopter.
We don't talk about you.
Helicopter faster and can bypass difficult terrain, but carry less and be careful with enemy AA or plane. Truck carry more, but can really move effectively in certain terrain. The more expensive you choose, the more supply per point you get. but in limited number, so be wise. FOB, it's your supply storage. Infantry trap, we got combat infantry, regular, shock, and elite. And support infantry, anti-air, anti-tank, engineer, and fire support. Combat infantry will hoard all fill your front line, while support infantry in the second line or defensive position. Also, infantry come with the transport, it adding the price. Transport have same veterancy as the infantry. Support, we got anti-air, howitzer, MRRS, and mortar. In anti-air, you got gun and missile AA, fire rate or damage. Also, you have radar and non-radar. Radar give extra range against plane, but can be countered by SEAD. Howitzer will provide you with boom boom. You have large caliber and medium. On large one, it provides you with high firepower but low range of fire. While medium on low end calculate the fire manually, so accuracy and aim time are worse. But hey, it's cheap way to give shell shock to the enemy. High end have computing system that give pinpoint accuracy, but it consume more supply. MRLS, HE, napalm, and cluster. Boom 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 boom. Area denial tool, anti vehicle, but please don't use it on infantry. And lastly, mortar. It's your local artillery. And for smoking, keep in mind artillery aim time and supply consumption depend on its type. Tank tap, it filled with brick tool and fire support. Despite the existence of advanced optic technology, all tank except in recon tap use World War II optic. This explains the low stat of optic in the tank. This is not an invisible stuff, so be careful how to use it. Recon tap, it's your eye on the battle. 5-man infantry for passive recon, 10-man one, used in more active way, and sniper team, it's for in enemy line or behind enemy line passive recon. While vehicle provides you with extra firepower and extra recon, but just don't buy the MG1 or with no armament one, it's waste of point. Helicopter with no armament or only MG, it's for passive recon, and the potent arm one are better in active way. Vehicle tap is trash bin with handful of good stuff, so you must sorting the trash that worth your time. That trash will be worthless in eye of all people, but it will do certain thing in your strategy. Heal tap basically fire support, anti-tank, anti-air, attack helicopter. It's your fast response unit that really dangerous if enemy doesn't have tool to counter it. Aircraft, air superiority, bomber, anti-tank, multi-role. And seat, ASF is your tool to keep air clear against enemy plane or helicopter. Depend on the loadout. Bomber, just like MRLS, have 3 type of warhead for a specific job, but bomb drop with delay. True anti-tank plane carry ATGM, while the fake one carry only rocket. They deliver the blow instantly, while the role of multi-role depend on loadout that it carry. So it's carry one of ASF job with one of anti-ground job. SEAD is your anti-radar. It's a good idea to bring two type of CV, infantry with more armor one, or you can swap one of these with Jeep CV if you want number one, cheaper truck with helicopter, or you swap helicopter with expensive truck. Infantry tap, one regular infantry are not enough in one match, so use two regular infantry. If you want good support, you can add AA or anti-tank. And last slot, you want a better infantry, so shock or elite. Transport, cheap one for spam ability, or the other one if you want firepower. So don't make all the unit expensive. At least have the cheaper one and expensive one, so you can respond properly in all situation. Support tap, mortar, expensive RT or the cheap one, definitely AA, one long range missile with non-radar or the cheap one for road-based defense. Tank, one expensive one with one medium price. Recon tap, 5-man one along with the cheaper vehicle for the backbone. You can put more expensive or more potent arm one here. Vehicle, you can put this auto cannon for base defense, or fire support option like this recoilless jeep and this vehicle. Okay, BMPT, the infantry killer. Heli tap, attack helicopter with cheaper fast response anti-tank helicopter. Plain tap. Okay, in general, you want expensive ASF with fire and forget, you can use the semi-active one. See it if you want anti-radar capability. And at least anti-soft or hard ground unit. Two anti-ground option with anti-helicopter one. Or you can focus on multi-role. Please create your own deck rather than using other people's deck, because you have feel of your deck more. It will be a worse deck, but with experience, you can change the deck in better shape. After creating the deck, you play some bot game in 1v1 map like Mudfight or Punchbowl. And remember, don't put difficulty too high, because the AI will cheat more, so they flex on you with spamming all the unit. In battle, there is a command bar. So, this is essential in battle. Move fast, make your vehicle move in public road. Reverse, make your vehicle reverse properly so they don't show their juicy butt at the enemy. Attack, make your unit stop and fire at enemy while they can. Fire position, manually fire weapon, only HE except for a cluster warhead. Split, make unit split. Regroup, make bigger stack. And spread. In urban area, infantry are the king. Forest area are for infantry or sometimes vehicle. And an open field, vehicle and tank. It's better to ask your friend to help you in this first match. If you didn't have one, of course, friend who play Wargame Red Dragon, you can hop to my Discord or other community. After few bot game, you can try campaign or multiplayer. Either play team game or 10v10. Remember to click this. Your first 10 match will be quite a struggle. But after get used to the game, eventually you enjoying the multiplayer experience. Just be prepared for a warm welcome from member of War Chat. Okay, that's all for today. I plan to making this because I see too many people spamming cluster to the infantry. Thank you for watching. See you later.